Well, not too long now to the start of the Ashes series. How much are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, I can't wait. It's the anticipation over the last month. Being back in Australia has been big. It's been building up there, and obviously coming over here in the last week, since the winding up of the 2020, the talk is about the Ashes now, and it's becoming pretty exciting.
And from your own personal point of view?
Yeah, look, I've had some great times over here, you know, playing some county cricket over the last 5 years, so it's a dream come true to come back now and be part of an Ashes tour. I was here in 2005 playing for Lancashire and being a spectator, but you know, now I can be back and be participating in, which is a dream come true.
You mentioned about the experience you've got of playing in England. You know, have you sort of told any of your sort of teammates any sort of things they need to think about when they play here?
Not really. I think a lot of the guys have been in the similar boat to me. A lot of the guys have played county cricket. The other guys have been over here and played in previous Ashes tours. But no, look, I guess it's nice to have the experience of being playing in English conditions and played on a lot of the grounds that we're playing the test matches on. So there won't be any surprises, you know, regarding conditions or facilities.
Contrasting series 2005 and 2006-07. What do you think this series will be won and lost?
Look, I think it's going to be another tight series, similar to 2005. Both teams have shown some form in their last Test series, but both have had a few transitional, a bit of a transitional stage. There's been some new players come in for both teams over the last couple of years, and so look, I expect it to be a tough contest. You know, I'd love to see a nice tight series, which I guess brings the crowd and the public involved in, but obviously the win going to us, not England.